I will show you how to navigate tab control based on the combo box value. So this is our category: fruit, milk, and fruit snack. So we will navigate tab control based on this value. Okay, now we will put some blank form. Now we'll insert tab control and we will make 3 pages. So now we will keep as is that one. So this one will rename page, let's say fruit, as per our category. Then fruit here, fruit milk, PG milk, then we'll put caption milk, and here page snack. Then we will put caption snack. Okay, so this tab control, we will navigate this one using our combo box with this particular category. Now we will put some text here just for you to show that this particular page intended for fruits. So we'll put here fruits. I will make it 48 red. Then we'll put some here also, design, and put milk again. We change to 48, then make blue. The other one will insert another text stack. Now we can see the difference is one. Okay, so since we are using very A, so we need to put tag. Each page we should put a tag here. So this one fruit, we'll put here tag fruit, and this one we'll put tag milk, and this one we'll put tag snack. Okay, now we will put a combo box. next. So we have category, next, next, next. So this is our category, finish. Select category, then CBO category. Okay, now if we will select this one, there's no any changes. Okay, now we'll proceed. First, we need to select this one, then event, then go to after update. Okay, now we will use some if statement. If me that CBO category that value, so this is the value, float equal float t, then now we need to put text box, because after selecting this value, our cursor should go to our text box as our sheet focus. Okay, now I will put text box here, design, so that every time after selection, the cursor must be focused here. I will rename txt focus. Okay, again, if CBO category value equals to float t, then we'll go to me.txt focus that set focus. Okay, then we put dim control, we'll put some abbreviation current as control. Then for each CTL core in me, our control, for each core in me dot control, then next, so loop, okay, if control current dot tag equals, so this is our tags here, each page have corresponding tag. Now we will use that one. If CTL current tag equal milk, we'll put double quote because we are dealing with string milk, or CTL core tag equal snack. So whatever the tag for our page with milk and snack should be or must be hidden. So now or not visible. CTL core dot visible equal false. So meaning milk and snack. So if fruit tea is our selection, so this tab page with tag milk and snack should not be visible because we are selecting only this category fruit tea, so this should only show, right? False. Then else if CTL core dot tag equal fruit, so this is our selection fruit, this one fruity, our tag is fruit, then that particular control must be visible equal true. Then we will close this F and F this one, so we will close. Now we will copy this one because here it's showing fruit tea, so we have another category. I will copy this one, and we have three categories. I will copy also. So another category fruit tea. Now this milk tea. So meaning if we will select milk tea, so whatever this one is the milk this one milk tea category here milk, so whatever tag of snack and fruit should be invisible and this milk should be visible. So again I will copy this one as our option, then we will paste here. Now we will put some, because this is CTL core, so we will put one because this we are dealing with another category, so we'll put core one. This one, we just only put one here and here and here and here. Okay, since we are selecting this milk tea, so we will put also here visible tag milk, and here this should be invisible or hide, so whatever tag for snack and fruit. So if there is a tag fruit and snack should be invisible and only tag with milk should be visible. Okay, last category is the prose snack. Again same situation, snack whatever tag milk and fruit, it will be invisible, only this snack it's coming visible. So now I will copy this one prose snack then we'll paste here. Since we have CTL Core 1, so we will also change here to 2 2 2 2 and here 2. Then this one, the tag for this one is snack. So this one is visible. Here, this one visible is true. And here milk will keep as is, and here we'll put fruit here. Fruit. Make sure that all this one, if you declare this one CTL Core 2, it should be all here is CTL Core 2. Just to avoid error, try to make sure. We'll check here. 1 1 1 1 1. Click quick and here save. Now we'll try. Since this is visible even without this one, we can navigate. Now we will hide this one, go to format, then style will make none, so that if we will open chewing fruits because we are selected this milk. Now look, if I will choose fruit, the problem here is I forgot to close this F statement, so should be, I will, this one is NF. This is the issue, I forgot to close that. That's why it's going to the next. Okay, I think this is correct. Now it's everything is fine. We will close this one. Now we will navigate milk tea. Look. For snack. Look. For tea. For snack. Look, if you say what if after I choose this one, fruit tea, automatically our cursor will go to the our TXT focus. Just make it this one is size is 0 to make it not visible. Look, this is it. This is how to navigate tab control with combo box based on our category option or combo box selected value. Thank you and God bless.